Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Alliterations. This month for October, I wanted to discuss a book I finished not too long ago, but I really enjoyed and I would like to talk about it a little bit. And that is Revelations of Divine Love by Julian of Norwich. I'm trying to get so it is less glare. There we go. Yeah, a really good book. A really interesting meditation. It's nonfiction again. Again, branching off a little bit from our usual fare. But I suppose that if you're a non-believing individual, you might consider it fiction anyway. So here we are. We cover all of our bases. It's about this woman Julian Nor Julian. She's an anchoress, Catholic saint now. She lived in the city of Norwich, England, and she was dying on her deathbed when she, a series of divine revelations. Or she called them showings, but with an E instead of an O, that made her feel at peace. Peace with her disease, peace with her fate, at peace with her, her death, at peace in knowing that, this isn't the end. And that there's a greater journey beyond. I thought it was a really touching piece. It's very short too. It's only not even, barely 200 pages. It's just when you're reading it. You feel the sense of security and not optimism, but maybe hope or maybe acceptance just sort of wash over you as well, like it washes over her or washed over her as she saw the passion of the Christ in these visions that she had on her deathbed. And given today's world, there's a lot of uncertainty. I think that's a fair thing to say. And it's regardless of any sort of belief you have, would be it religious, political, societal, cultural, there's a lot of uncertainty. And I know that it's something that I know people in particular in my generation have felt for a long time is this sense of insecurity. We've sort of lacked a grounding force. And then, but then reading this book, you kind of feel that there is a grounding force. It's something, a higher force, higher power that gives us hope, that gives us the strength to accept what has befallen us, whether that's a disease, whether that's a personal situation, whether it's a societal situation, doesn't matter. Reading this book, you can you learn how to apply the idea that this is not the end, that this is just a step in the journey. And a really interesting story that she tells. So I know that we don't know much about Julian of Norwich. This book is the oldest book that we have written in English, written by a woman. Like I said, she was a an anchoress in the city of Norwich in England. She died around 1415, and that's about all that we know about her. So yeah, it's like I said, it's not a it's not she's not a great well-known figure. She's an everyman, and she eventually got better after seeing these visions. But there was a miracle cure, or a the strength of her resolve, or whatever it may be. She improved after having these visions. I believe it was 16 visions total. Most of them in one night, and then one of them the next night. And she ended up writing this book, the story of her visions, the story of her recovery. And it's a really, I found it good. I read a, it wasn't this specific copy, it was one that was broken up to be like daily meditations. And I read it over the course of a month or so, the daily meditations. And like I said, I felt that peace and that comfort, that acceptance come into my life. The title, that version was titled All Will Be Well. And I think that that's something that's really applicable to our world. Rather than being allegorical, it's very much so applicable to our world that, we've faced tough times before. We've faced down our death on our deathbed, but we, as individuals, we as a societies, we as the human race, have stepped up to the plate, so to speak, and have continued to improve, continued to live, continued to thrive for the most part, through some horrible experiences, again, with be they personal or worldwide impact, personal, like an addiction or an accident or an illness, or like I said, worldwide, World War One, World War Two, COVID pandemic, whatever it is you want to pick. And we've still managed to push forward. And like I said, I think that that's a really important message to send to people, is to keep on pushing forward, to keep your past in perspective. Your past is not your future. And that you can make improvements to your life, and that you can be accepting of your suffering, which you keep, but you don't let it define you. Again, Julian of Norwich is a perfect example of that. She's not remembered. She's not defined by her illness. We don't even necessarily know what it is. But what she's defined by is her resolve, to the strength of her resolve, the resolve to keep on going, her resolve to write down her story and to make an impact on future generations. And that's what we can do too. At least that was, like I said, that was my takeaway from Julian of Norwich's Revelations of Divine Love. I would, like I said, highly recommend people read it, check it out. If you're not Catholic, that's okay. There's not, it's not a doctrine heavy text. You don't like that she's a saint, that's fine. You don't have to think about her as a saint. Just think about her as, she's 100 or so years before Shakespeare. You know what I mean? Think of her, read her as you would read Chaucer or Shakespeare or the Pearl Poet or whoever else. Thomas More, again, you pick your person, and realize that she lived the experiences that so many of us still do. As you're reading her, know that you're not alone, as evidenced by Julian of Norwich. Thanks again, everybody. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Stay tuned for more. Looking forward to doing some more of these. So, thank you.